province of Isabela remains a moderate risk area amid the coronavirus outbreak. Let's get an update on the situation there from Isabela Governor Rodito Albano III. Good afternoon, Governor, and thank you for joining us.
Yes, good afternoon, Rain. Good afternoon to all your viewers.
You had a meeting with mayors of Isabela yesterday. Are you going to maintain the enhanced community quarantine in Isabela province?
It's likely so that we're going to maintain that ECQ. And we had the meeting with the mayors yesterday, you know, and they were asking that the bank should be open from Monday to Friday, because the banking hours here are 9 to 12 only, and it's NWF. So they're requesting that we write a letter and we make a resolution for the banks to open daily and to have banking hours restored to 9 to, 8 to 5, I think. Those are the banking hours. So not to congest the banks and not to have mass gatherings in their branches.
So when are you set to make a decision on whether you're going to maintain an ECQ? Currently, what status are you in?
Currently, we're on the moderate GCQ.
And so,
I think the IATF announced that a while ago, or the president announced that we are on a GCQ, general quarantine, general community quarantine.
It doesn't,
which is lower than the ECQ.
So when are you going to come out with a decision on whether you're going to upgrade to an enhanced ECQ?
We're not going to upgrade. We can't upgrade. You know, we're going to ask from the regional IATF if they'll allow us to go into an ECQ, or we can go into a modified ECQ. So all these requests should be channeled, as they say in the IATF, it should be channeled to the regional IATF.
Mm-hmm. And what will be your basis for this modified ECQ? How many people are infected with COVID-19 in your province now? How many have died and recovered? Does this, Governor,
yes.
Does this COVID count warrant an extended ECQ?
Yeah, we have two COVID patients in Santiago, Southern Isabela Medical Center. It's located in Santiago. Hello?
Yes, Governor.
It's located in Santiago City. We have two cases there, and we have about 38 PUIs in Santiago City, and also in Tuguegarao, in the Cagayan Valley Medical Center. We have about 12 cases of 12 cases of PUIs. Severe PUIs, I think, from different towns in Isabela.
Governor, we're actually looking at on screen the report of the COVID cases of your Integrated Provincial Health Office in Isabela. Now, President Duterte had been teasing a modified community quarantine last night, so certain sectors could resume operations. In your province, what sectors are the hardest hit? Is it agriculture, retail, and transport? What will you prioritize apart from the banks?
Transport. What do you mean with what I prioritize? Prioritize to open?
In a modified community quarantine setup, what will you prioritize in opening up?
Yes, I'll open the infrastructure to provide economic stimulus here and to prepare for the rainy season. We're to open our public infrastructure, like river controls, bridges stopped work.
All right, so banks and infrastructure projects, especially for the rainy season. Now, what kind of deployment of resources do you currently have to ensure that residents of Isabela follow social distancing measures? I hear in several market areas this is not being followed. What are the penalties and punishment for non-compliance?
Other ordinances set up by local. There are local ordinances here that if you don't wear a mask, there will be sanctions. If you don't practice this social distancing, you'll be put in in quarantine area, so forth and so on. You know, I leave it up to the mayors to to produce such ordinances. It's the mayors who know their what's this locality better. So I leave it up to them. I give them the autonomy to do so.
So this 3 hours of community service and a fine of 500 pesos for failure to wear a face mask, is that implemented throughout the whole province?
I don't know. It depends upon the municipality, Munsi.
Now, finally, Governor Albano, what assistance has your province provided to how many residents, and what kind of further assistance is needed, perhaps from the national government and the private sector?
Yeah, what we did here, Munsi, is we buy local produce. So what happens is agricultural, we went to what's this, our economic stimuli here is all concentrated on that is buying local produce such as calabansi, bananas, pineapples, fries, some sort of any local produce, juices that are produced by municipalities, eggs, red eggs, balot, pogo eggs, so forth and so on. So we encourage the local producers, and we buy local produce. It's the province who buys the local produce and gives it to packs it and gives it as relief goods to our localities.
So how much in funds have you actually mobilized for this economic stimulus, as well as how many beneficiaries have you logged in?
All households, of course. All households. We try to give everybody, especially our frontliners and all those quarantined, that's about, if I'm not mistaken, about 450,000 households. Also, we try to, we spent already about 40 million buying vitamins, buying all those local produce, locally produced products from different towns to give it to all those households.
All right. Isabella, Governor Rodito Albano III will be waiting for your decision on that modified community quarantine that you hope to implement in the province. Thank you so much for joining us, Governor Albano.
Thank you, Bunsi. Thank you, Bunsi. Thank you very much, too.